Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at putting files and folders on the right side of the dock. So the left side of the dock has app icons. On the right side, to the right of the divider line, you've got files, folders, and the trash can. On this episode, we're going to look at files and folders. And by default, you get one folder in there. It's the downloads folder. If I click on it, it jumps up. This is what's called a stack. And it's this stack has just one file in it, something I recently downloaded, and Open and Finder at the top. If I click on Open Finder, it's going to show me the downloads folder. And you can see downloads is located in the user folder under downloads. Matter of fact, I can jump up there and I can see there's downloads. And this is actually where the files are. It's important to realize that the files are in those folders. This is a shortcut or an alias to it. So it's basically showing you a mirror of what's in here, but the real stuff is in here. It's important to realize because people think that when they remove things from the docs, they've deleted them. But in fact, they just deleted the shortcut to them. Matter of fact, I can take this here. I'm going to click and drag it up until it says remove. Remove it. Now it's no longer there, but notice my downloads folder didn't go anywhere. And in fact, if I go up and grab downloads and drag it back in, I can return it there because it never left my hard drive. It just simply left the dock. The shortcut to it was here. The real thing was here. And this means you can add your own folders to it. So let's, for instance, grab the documents folder here and also add that to the right side here. I can't add it to the left, that's for apps, but I can add it to the right. And now I have a stack that shows me my documents folder. And I have the same thing here except I've got more things in the documents folder. If I wanted to open something, I could just click on it right here. So it's very quick and easy to go to. I can open the entire folder here, or I can open a folder that's inside this folder here. I have some options though. If that's not a really good view for me, I can control click here and I can change to a fan view, which is what we saw, but I could change to a grid view, which is this, which will display more items and maybe a way that you like better. List view is the ultimate view because not only does it show me options and open and find here at the bottom, really easy to get to, but it shows me all the files. There's plenty of room for lots of files, and I can dig down into subfolders right here. So I like foreseeing into list view. If you do automatic view, it'll choose the one that makes the most sense. So if you've got a lot of items in the folder, you should see a list. But fewer items, you should see a fan. And maybe in certain conditions, you'll see a grid. But I usually like to set things to what I want. Also notice I can set the sorting. So I can sort this by different ways. And I can also set how it's displayed. Displayed as a stack shows me, you can see like there's a folder and a bunch of files and here's a file. I can just say, no, just show me the folder. I can do the same thing for this one here. So if you like that better, you can switch to that option. Now you can also just put a file there. So for instance, in my documents folder, say if this is a document I need to get to a lot, I can put it there. And this isn't a stack, it's just that single file, and I can easily click on it to open it up. So say there's something you need to fill out every day, a spreadsheet you update constantly or something like that. Adding it to your doc as a quick way to access that might be a good way to go. Now to show an extreme example of using this, you can go to the Applications folder. Let's go out one level here so I can see my Applications folder. Let's drag that into the stack. And there I've got the Applications folder. I can click on it and it will open up in a grid view. Let me change that to List View. And now I click on that and you can see every application here. It even will scroll. And anytime there's a subfolder, I can dig down into it. I can dig down into subfolders of subfolders. So it's very easy to basically have access to everything in a very complex folder like the Applications folder here. This could be an Applications launcher to rival Launchpad, for instance, because you can get to everything. And if you have a Documents folder that has tons of folders and subfolders and sub-subfolders, you can put the Documents folder here and then be able to get to all the items that you've got through the doc if that's the way you prefer to do it. Now I should point out there's something else that can appear here on the right. Say I'm editing a document. Here I am in text edit and I minimize it, hitting the yellow button. You could see the window goes down here. So in addition to files, folders, the trash can all the way over to the right, you also have minimized windows. I still have text edit running. If I click on that, it will pop out of the right side of the dock and back onto the screen. So it's just a way to minimize things and have quick access to them without having to go to the app. In the app here I can actually go to TextEdit and then the window and grab it that way as well. Notice if I were to minimize something and then quit the app that it goes away. So it's only things that are actively open but just minimized. You can't drag these minimized windows over to the left like you can with apps. When an app is open it appears here and I could drag it over to add it permanently there. You can't do that here with documents. They're just these temporary windows. So files, folders, windows that are minimized, and the trash can. That's what comprises the right side of the dock.